The European geopolitical point of view, the Balkans have always been difficult to understand and both territories. The important connection point between Europe and Asia, the land infrastructure is mostly common associated with trade routes to the Middle and Far East.
Nowadays, the Balkans continue to have some problems, but the weather of change started to blow again, and if I dare to say, to better future. Some of the contributing factors to this improvement and increased intensity of relations between Central and Eastern European countries are related to the Chinese initiative 16+1 and Belt and Road. This is the map of the Balkans. You can see this Black Sea and Bulgaria. The location of Bulgaria is southeastern part of Balkan Peninsula. I would like to stress on a few key points here. West Balkans are something like the hot topic of the future. Even for our presidency of the Council of the European Union next year, Bulgaria will have the West Balkans as a priority in regard to future European Union enlargement plans. It's very important for us, the most important. Nevertheless, we should not forget the importance of the East Balkans because they have their geopolitical strengths, big harbors on Black Sea, political and economical stability, already they are members of the Union and final frontier. Only united, the Balkans will progress and step ahead. This united, I stress many times on this unification, united, by analogy of Chinese philosophy of harmony and peaceful development. As Professor David Gossett from Academia Sinica in Shanghai noted in the 5-Euro-China Forum, Bulgaria is a key component of the Black Sea system. This system has been traditionally connecting the two edges of Eurasia. It was a part of Marco Polo's journeys on the Silk Road. Nestorian monk Rabban Salvan, envoy of Chinese emperor, also crossed it. The Black Sea system plays an important role to play in the construction of more cooperative Eurasia. The geopolitics of the wider Black Sea region suggests that it will be important for the development of the Silk Road economic belt, which spreads over this territory. On this path is the Europe-Caucasus-Asia transport corridor. Part of it is the connection between Georgia and Bulgaria and also Romanian seaports, respectively Poti, Varna, Burgas and Constanța. This is the map, Georgia Poti, just crossed the Black Sea from eastern to western part, and now is Bulgarian port Varna. The continuation from Bulgaria seaports to another corridors is being strategically addressed at the moment. Our Prime Minister Boyko Borisov and the Transport Information Technology Communication Minister Ivailo Moskovsky have signed memorandum on a rail transport corridor with the Greek Prime Minister Alexis Tsipras and their infrastructure, transport and network minister Christos Pirzitsis. This event expresses the political willingness of Bulgaria and Greece to create a transport corridor of the Aegean Sea, Black Sea, Danube axis, named Sea to Sea. The project will develop the transport corridor concept by executing connection between the ports of Thessaloniki, Kavala, and Alexandropolis from the Aegean Sea to Burgas, Varna, and Trusa. Now we can see the map throughout railway links, creating a full multimodal corridor, which is in compliance with the core trans-European transport network, so it could possibly get financed by Juncker Plan and Juncker Plan and European Investment Bank. Few of the important benefits of this corridor. Alexandropolis, it's in Greece, has become a strategic port which provides fast connection to Burgas and Varna, Bulgarian seaports. And according to the experts, the cost of the railway transport will be much lower in terms of dues. It will bypass the Bosphorus and Dardanelles straits in Turkey and will reduce the travel time from 2 days to 6 hours. Of course, this is not only about time. The situation in Turkey is not as easily predicted as in the past, so the construction of this corridor is strategically supported. Rusevarna connection will increase. Rusevarna, Varna is on Black Sea, Ruse Danube. This distance is only 150 kilometers. Connection will increase the benefits because it will give access not only between the seas, but also to one of the main transport arteries of Europe, Danube River. The tentative cost of the project in its Bulgarian section is around 1,070,000 euro. About Greece, around 4 million. And the transport facilities are supposed to be built within 10 years or so. Danube strategy will also play part in the defending of the proposed project. And this is corridor number 8, Varna and Burgas. This is Bulgaria, Sofia capital. And after that, Macedonia and Albania. Pan-European transport corridors, very famous for all of Europe, not only for this part. And you can see Varna, Black Sea, this Black Sea, from Burgas to Middle East, from Varna to Ukraine and Russia, from Russia to Black Sea, and another direction, many directions, Skopje, Tirana, Alexandroupolis, Greece, Thessaloniki, Athens again, Greece, Istanbul, Turkey. Another important corridor that goes from Bulgaria, Black Sea coast is just this Pan-European corridor number 8. In this regard, the recent development of the relations between Bulgaria and Greece could also be been seen as something positive. There is a political will to strengthen the ties between the two states, which is articulated with the sign of treaty, a friendship, good neighbor lines, and cooperation. This act was necessary and it will boost the infrastructure cooperation as well as other sectors. Most important, it is another step to finally start working on this corridor right. This will link Black Sea, Adriatic Sea via Bulgaria, Macedonia, and Albania. Something that was too long postponed for different reasons, but will be of great benefit for the development of the countries on this east-west axis. During the meeting in July with Zoran Zaev, our foreign minister Ekaterina Zakharieva said that building Corridor 8 will be high priority for both countries. Just to mention that last month, during the World China Central Eastern European Countries Cultural Cooperation Forum in Hangzhou, Bulgaria did the right thing, as other countries in 16 plus one initiative, in supporting the establishment of a China CEE Cultural Cooperation Center in Macedonia. I'll get back on this corridor in a few seconds. Bulgaria and Macedonia will build the rail link between Sofia and Skopje through frontier city. Must have been completed by many years, after many years, 2027. Understanding between Ministry of Transport, Information Technology and Communication of the Republic of Bulgaria and the Ministry of Transport and Communication of the Republic of Macedonia on the development of the railway links between Sofia and Skopje. The Bulgarian state is committed to the construction of the railway link between Sofia and Pernik-Radomir, Bulgarian cities and Macedonia's border. Macedonia in charge of the construction, this city, Kriva Palanka, maybe town in Macedonia. Bulgaria and Albania. Albania, the other concerning party in this initiative, is also experiencing boost in the bilateral relation with Bulgaria. The government in Tirana voted for the amendments to the Minority Protection Bill, approved by consensus in the country's parliamentary legal committee, that there is a Bulgarian minority and now it is officially recognized by Albania. I told you everything this because the situation in Balkans really, there are so many problems between our countries, so small countries, but so many problems. Bulgaria, Serbia. After building new parts of the highway after city of Niš in Serbia, the connection between both countries is getting better. In this regard, a good boost in Bulgaria will give the parliament voting for a launch of toll road system, which should come in action next year. This will untie the hands of the government when they are proposing projects for big investors, and Chinese companies have already expressed their interest in this sector in Bulgaria, infrastructure sector. Again, back to Corridor 8. I will give my expert opinion on this subject because there is some contradiction about it. There is a belief that the signed Memorandum of Understanding with Greece in Kavala is to block the realization of this project. I dare to say that C2C and via Ignatia are not mutually exclusive. Here are some facts. The direct railroad connection from Thessaloniki to Igoumenitsa, Igoumenitsa is still to be constructed, as is also Thessaloniki Kavala Ksanti. The same case with another Lerin, it's Pogradec, Ohrid Lake to Durres, Durres in Albania, with some small exception, Thessaloniki Plati, the railroad is not electrified in North Greece from the border of Bulgaria with Bulgaria. In many places, there are no railway lines at all. And wherever they are, all are one way. The modernization of this line to Alexandropolis has not been accomplished. Only partial rehabilitation of this line from Thessaloniki has been done. The situation of railroad transport on this corridor right is as follows. Bulgaria is working on the modernization from Burgas to Sofia. Burgas is Black Sea to Sofia capital western part, with more than two-thirds of the distance being a two-way electrified line. After that, Gyuresheva in Romania should be just Danube should be upgraded and electrified from a very small Bulgarian town near the border with Serbia to the border in Macedonia, just border Serbia and Macedonia. New section should be built from another small towns reach to Albania. These sections are much shorter than those of the corridor Ignatia. Maybe you don't know many towns. The remaining route from Kumanovo to Kichevo is for modernization, but what want to say? At first sight, Greece has a significant advantage over Bulgaria, Vardar, Macedonia and Albania, because A2, it's only in Greece, A2, it's a corridor, it's a transport corridor, is entry ready for the southern neighbors, and next year it is expected to complete the rehabilitation. On the other hand, if we analyze the highway route from Burgas to Dupnica, Bulgaria is ready to do it. To the west part, there is a ready route, Western Balkans, I mean. Another they're ready to do. In Albania, the highway from Durres to Tirana again is ready. It is being built next. And lastly, if the destination is Kavala from Bulgaria to Greece, it's northern part of Greece or Alexandroupolis, then it goes through Svilengrad, it's Bulgarian. The same arguments apply equally to Varna and Truse. Whatever Greece does, it cannot stop Corridor 8 and it will be gradually built. And only a few words about 16+1. Yesterday in Bulgaria there is open one Chinese cultural center, very big buildings, eight floors. There are two Confucius Institute. Bulgaria is very small country, population 7 million. So many Chinese there in Bulgaria. Especially in this people-to-people connectivity work very, very hardly. And our countries, I want to say that we must unify it because 16+1, so different countries, West Balkans, Eastern Balkans, and European Union, non-European Union. Different culture, yeah. And Chinese said that 16+1 is experimental laboratory of Europe. Maybe you know that tomorrow they'll open high-level summit 16+1 in Budapest. And now a prime minister will be there. I want to say about think tank network in this 16+1, and we organize many conferences. For example, only this year, more than 10 conferences, 16+1. Thank you so much.